Hello everyone. Today I'll start with chapter number 14, that is respiration in plants. In the previous sessions, we understood how the photosynthesis that takes place in green plants. Photosynthesis, it is an anabolic process in which organic food molecules are synthesized in green plants from simpler substances like carbon dioxide and water in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll. Oxygen is released as a byproduct and photosynthesis that takes place in a special apparatus. That apparatus is nothing but chloroplast. And then we understood what are photosynthetic pigments. Pigments which absorb light energy for the photochemical reaction. There are two types. One is said to be primary, second one is said to be accessory. Primary means it absorbs light energy and convert this light energy into chemical energy, and the second one is said to be accessory, so that here the pigments which absorb light energy and immediately pass it on to primary pigment. And then these pigments which are present inside the thylakoids as a functional unit, and these are said to be quantosomes or photosystem, and the common energy receiving point is said to be reaction center. So there are two types of photosystem, 1 and 2. The reaction center is P700 in case of photosystem 1. Reaction center is P680 in case of photosystem 2. And then we studied some of the experiment. Carbon dioxide is necessary for photosynthesis, light is necessary for photosynthesis, and then there will be an evolution of oxygen during photosynthesis. And then coming to the very important aspect is the mechanism of photosynthesis. It's a redox reaction in which water is get oxidized to oxygen in case of light reaction, carbon dioxide is reduced to the level of carbohydrate in case of dark reaction. And then we studied C4 cycle, and then chemiosmotic pathway, synthesis of ATP in the chloroplast. And then we studied number of factors which affects the rate of photosynthesis. And then coming to the next is the respiration. Respiration means it is a catabolic process. It is a destructive process in which what happens, the glucose is broken down into simpler substances like carbon dioxide and water with the release of energy. So it is a catabolic process in which the glucose is broken down through oxidation with the release of energy, so that the total equation is glucose, oxygen, carbon dioxide, water plus energy. We have to balance this. Glucose is broken down into simpler substances like carbon dioxide and water in the presence of oxygen, or through oxidation there will be a release of energy. This is said to be respiration. So there are two types of respiration. First one is aerobic respiration, second one is anaerobic respiration. Aerobic respiration means it is a complete oxidation of glucose into simpler substances like carbon dioxide and water in the presence of oxygen with the release of large amount of energy, so that it takes place in almost all the higher organisms. Anaerobic respiration means partial oxidation or incomplete oxidation of glucose into simpler substances in the absence of oxygen with the release of small amount of energy so that it takes place in very few organisms, that is nothing but some of the microbes like bacteria and yeast. So there are two types of respiration, aerobic, anaerobic. Here aerobic means complete oxidation, incomplete oxidation, in the presence of oxygen, in the absence of oxygen, with the release of large amount of energy, with the release of small amount of energy. And here the substance which undergoes oxidation, that is said to be respiratory substrate. It may be the glucose, or it may be the fats, or it may be the proteins. So these are all said to be respiratory substrate. Now let's understand the mechanism of aerobic respiration. Mechanism of aerobic respiration. Mechanism of aerobic respiration, that includes four steps. First is glycolysis, second is formation of acetyl CoA, coenzyme A, third one is Krebs cycle, last is electron transport system. So there are four steps. First is said to be glycolysis, second is the formation of acetyl CoA, third is Krebs cycle, this is also known as tricarboxylic acid cycle, last is said to be electron transport system. Now we'll understand one by one. First coming to the glycolysis. As the name itself indicates, glyco, glucose, lysis, splitting, that means the glucose is broken down into two molecules of pyruvic acid. So the first is glycolysis. It takes place in the cytoplasm, in which a molecule of glucose is broken down into two molecules of pyruvic acid. It takes place in the cytoplasm. It does not require oxygen, so that it is considered as an anaerobic part of aerobic respiration. Now let's understand how the glycolysis that takes place in the cytoplasm. Coming to the next is glycolysis. Also known as EMP pathway. Glycolysis is also known as EMP pathway because the name of the scientist who identified this glycolysis, Emden, Meyerhoff and Parnas pathway. So glycolysis, it is a process in which a molecule of glucose is broken down into two molecules of pyruvic acid, and it takes place in the cytoplasm. Now we'll understand the one by one step. First is glucose. Glucose is phosphorylated by ATP to form glucose 6-phosphate. That means glucose accept phosphate group from ATP to form glucose 6-phosphate. Next, glucose 6-phosphate, it is an isomer of fructose 6-phosphate. Fructose 6-phosphate. Isomer means same molecular formula having different structural formula. Glucose 6-phosphate, it is an isomer of fructose 6-phosphate. Now, this fructose 6-phosphate again phosphorylated by ATP to form fructose 1,6-diphosphate. First is glucose is phosphorylated by ATP to form glucose 6-phosphate, which is an isomer of fructose 6-phosphate. Fructose 6-phosphate again accepts a phosphate group from ATP to form fructose 1,6-diphosphate. Now, this fructose 1,6-diphosphate splits into two molecules. One is dihydroxyacetone phosphate. And phosphoglyceraldehyde. That is 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde. Again, these two are isomers. I repeat, fructose 1,6-diphosphate is splits into two trios. First is dihydroxyacetone phosphate and 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde. From here, this 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde, I'll write it here. Three-phosphoglyceraldehyde is phosphorylated by phosphoric acid. At the same time, dehydrogenated to form 1,3-diphosphoglyceric acid. Here what happens? 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde is phosphorylated by phosphoric acid. At the same time, there will be a removal of 2 hydrogen, that is said to be dehydrogenated, to form 1,3-diphosphoglyceric acid. Here pair of hydrogen is accepted by NAD plus, which is reduced to NADH+, H+. Now, pair of hydrogen is accepted by coenzyme, that is nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide, so that which is reduced to NADH+, H+. Now, this 1,3-diphosphoglyceric acid is converted into 3-phosphoglyceric acid. Here a phosphate group is released, which is accepted by ADP to form ATP. Then this 3-phosphoglyceric acid is converted into 2 phosphoglyceric acid. Glyceric acid. By shift in a position of phosphate from third carbon to second carbon, there will be a shift in a position of phosphate from third carbon to second carbon. Then 2-phosphoglyceric acid is converted into phosphoenol pyruvate. There will be a removal of water. Last is phosphoenol pyruvate is converted into pyruvic acid. Here there will be a release of phosphate, which is accepted by ADP to form ATP. 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde is phosphorylated by phosphoric acid, dehydrogenated to form 1,3-diphosphoglyceric acid. 1,3-diphosphoglyceric acid is converted into 3-phosphoglyceric acid. Here there will be a release of phosphate, which is accepted by ADP to form ATP. 3-phosphoglyceric acid is converted into 2-phosphoglyceric acid by shift in a position of phosphate from third carbon to second carbon. Then there will be a removal of water, so converted into phosphoenol pyruvate, which is finally converted into pyruvic acid. Here there will be a release of phosphate, which is accepted by ADP to form ATP. So now from 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde there will be a formation of one molecule of pyruvic acid, so that this dihydroxyacetone phosphate is isomerized to 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde. There will be a formation of one more pyruvic acid. So as a result of this, the glucose is broken down into 2 molecules of pyruvic acid. I repeat, glucose first is phosphorylated by ATP to form glucose 6-phosphate, which is an isomer of fructose 6-phosphate. Fructose 6-phosphate is again phosphorylated by ATP to form fructose 1,6-diphosphate. Fructose 1,6-diphosphate, it splits into dihydroxyacetone phosphate and 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde. Again, these two are isomers. 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde now phosphorylated by phosphoric acid, dehydrogenated to form 1,3-diphosphoglyceric acid. 1,3-diphosphoglyceric acid is now converted into 3-phosphoglyceric acid. Phosphate group is released, accepted by ADP to form ATP. And here also there will be a removal of 2 hydrogen, which is accepted by coenzyme, that is NAD, nicotinamide, adenine, dinucleotide, which is reduced to NADH+H+. And then this 3-phosphoglyceric acid is converted into 2-phosphoglyceric acid by shift in a position of phosphate from third carbon to second carbon. And then 2-phosphoglyceric acid is dehydrated to form phosphoenol pyruvate. This phosphoenol pyruvate is converted into pyruvic acid. A phosphate group is released, accepted by ADP to form ATP. So that from 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde there will be a formation of 1 molecule of ATP. So that this dihydroxyacetone phosphate is isomerized to 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde, there will be a formation of 1 more pyruvic acid. Now we'll calculate how many ATP molecules are synthesized during glycolysis. Now here this is the one ATP, this is 1 more ATP. So if from 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde or there will be a formation of one molecule of pyruvic acid that results in 2 ATP. So that there will be a formation of 2 pyruvic acid. So finally results in 4 ATP molecules. Plus, and then here NADH plus H plus. How many NADH plus H plus? There are 2 NADH. There are 2 NADH plus H plus. These are the product of glycolysis. Now, this 4 ATP plus oxidation of this 1 NADH plus H plus, that results in 3 ATP molecules, so that this 3 into 2, now it becomes 6. So totally 4 plus 6, it becomes 10 ATP molecules. Now in the preparatory stage, we already used 1 and 2 ATP molecules. So minus 2, so 10 minus 2 now becomes 8. So glycolysis, that results in 8 ATP molecules. Very, very important, I repeat. In a glycolysis, there will be a formation of 2 molecules of pyruvic acid, so that 4 ATP plus 2 NADH plus H, these are the products. In the glycolysis process, there will be a formation of 4 ATP and 2 NADH plus H plus. So oxidation of 1 NADH plus H plus, that results in 3 ATP, so that 3 into 2 it becomes 6. So 4 plus 6 it becomes 10. So in the previous step, that means in the preparatory stage, we already utilized 2 ATP, and then 10 minus 2, the net gain of ATP is 8 molecules. So this is about glycolysis. A molecule of glucose is broken down into 2 molecules of pyruvic acid, and then the glucose in this process results in total 8 ATP molecules. So this is about the glycolysis process. Respiration means it is an oxidation of glucose into simpler substances with the release of energy in the form of ATP. So there are 2 types of respiration. The one is said to be aerobic, second one is said to be anaerobic. And here aerobic means is a complete oxidation, anaerobic means partial oxidation. Then we understood the first step in aerobic respiration, mechanism of aerobic respiration, that contains 4 stages: glycolysis, formation of acetyl-CoA, Krebs cycle, electron transport system. And then we understood how the glycolysis takes place in the cytoplasm. A molecule of glucose is broken down into 2 molecules of pyruvic acid: glucose, glucose-6-phosphate, fructose-6-phosphate, fructose-1,6-diphosphate, dihydroxyacetone phosphate, 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde, and then 1,3-diphosphoglyceric acid, 3-phosphoglyceric acid, 2-phosphoglyceric acid, phosphoenol pyruvate, then pyruvic acid. That results in 8 ATP molecules. So I hope you understood this session. Thank you.